Ah, the rainbow whiptail lizard. Ever heard of them? Probably not, and I don't understand why. These have got to be one of the coolest small lizards I've ever had, not to mention the insane colors. I mean, just take a look at this thing. We've got these variations of greens, blues, yellows, spots, scales. It's a magnificent lizard, and yet, there's barely any of them out there. But hey, that's not the question today. The question of the day is going to be, is the rainbow whiptail the right lizard for you? Of course, to answer that, we're gonna be going over our four big categories, that being the personality of the lizard, cost of ownership, overall care, and then lastly, the recommended experience I recommend you have before getting one. So with all that being said, I guess it's time to sit back, relax, dive into the rainbow whiptail lizard, and roll the intro. Kicking off this video, we are going to be starting with topic number one, the personality of the rainbow whiptail. Now, I'm not going to go ahead and sugarcoat this. The rainbow whiptail kind of sucks as far as the personality goes. I mean, quite honestly, at the end of the day, the rainbow whiptail is pretty much a cooler, more colorful version of an anole lizard. Pretty much just zipping around the enclosure, hiding, trying to stay out of sight. They're not really a handleable lizard if you can get hands on. Usually, you know, in these videos, I usually have the animal with me and we can check it out while I talk, but it just doesn't work with the rainbow whiptail, man. That thing is gonna be zipping around. I'm gonna be doing like this the whole time. It looks like I'm juggling. That's what I'll do. I'll be juggling rainbow whiptails while making this video. Quite honestly, that probably is the biggest drawback or con of the rainbow whiptail, the fact that it just kind of has a crap personality. But I don't think that means to say, like, why is it more popular just because it doesn't have a great personality? I mean, there are plenty of lizards in the reptile community that we have that don't have great personalities, and yet we like hold them on this high ground like they're amazing. But yeah, while not a hands-on animal, it definitely makes for an amazing display animal with a nice enclosure with some plants and logs going everywhere. It's pretty cool. I really enjoy heading up to the building, and it's really the first lizard I look at. It's out, like, sprawled out, basking with its eyes closed. Then as soon as it realizes you're there, it's like, oh no, zoop. But all right, moving on, let's get into the second topic at hand, which is going to be number two, the cost of ownership for your rainbow whiptail. Now, as far as the cost of ownership goes to the lizard, it's really far on the cheap end. Probably one of the cheaper animals you can get as far as caring goes. As far as enclosure, you're looking at somewhere between a 20 to 40 gallon, some nice topsoil sand mix. They do live usually on like the sandy beaches, so like a 50-50 of sand topsoil would be good for them. And that's about it. Basking bulb, UVB, and you're good to go. They don't require a massive enclosure. They do while requiring UVB. I think that's the pinnacle of like their expense list. Of course, staying at a small size, you're just gonna need small rodents or insects, sorry, not rodents, you know, roaches, crickets, things like that, just half sizes. All in all, they're a pretty cheap animal to take care of. All right, Dakota. I might not have the best personality, but it sounds like a pretty cheap lizard to take care of. But hang on, what does the care look like for the rainbow? I bet it's horrible, it's super hard to take care of, and that's why no one sees it. Well, we'll be going over that right now with number three, the overall care of the rainbow whiptail. Now, like I mentioned earlier, I really compare these guys to the anoles, just again, a like more pimped out version. It's like the anoles, like the base character in a video game, and then like rainbow whiptail is like the cool skin you can buy for like $3.99 for some reason, and people do it. Looking at you, Fortnite players. As far as the heating and lighting goes, you're gonna want an ambient of around 110 degrees, with a cool side being around 78 ambient and the hot side being around 90 ambient. Again, I also brushed up a little bit on the substrate. You're gonna want something like a topsoil sand mix of 50-50. In the wild, they are found, well, the wilds of Florida, they are found on the, you know, a little bit sandier beaches, so that'll be nice. Of course, Florida humidity, it's gonna be high. You're gonna want high humidity, somewhere around that 60 to 70% will make for a happy lizard. Lots of the diet is wicked easy, of course, a variety of small insects, you know, crickets, roaches, mealworms, superworms, all of that good stuff would be great for them. With your proper vitamin dusting, you know, the D3, calcium, and then the herbivites in the respective order. Don't think I mentioned it, UVB as well. You're gonna want UVB. I prefer the Linear T5 5.0s. However, you know, those things work too. If you're using a 20 gallon, that might work, but I do think the T5s would just stay a little bit better. Yeah, I mean, pretty much just your average lizard, you know, Noli care, rainbow whiptail care, they seem fairly similar. Of course, they're found in the, generally around the same area, so it's no wonder. Yeah, high humidity, high temps, and nice shady substrate, and then, put some stuff in there, you know, fake plants, logs, something for them to climb on, and they'll appreciate it, and that'll make for one happy lizard. And alright folks, this brings us down to our last category on this list. We talked a little about the overall care, the personality of the animal, and how much it costs. Pretty much as far, you know, personality not that great, but cheap animal and easy to care for, seems like not that bad of a pet. But we'll figure out the last part of this video, which is going to be number four, the recommended experience I recommend you have before getting a rainbow whiptail. Yeah, I really think this can be a great pet for pretty much any style or skill set of reptile keeping. Whether this could be your first time pet, I got a couple of pet reptiles, or you just have, you know, hundreds of reptiles like me, but you want one more that's a cool display animal. These guys are fairly easy to take care of, they're pretty cheap to own, and I don't know, I think they're just cool, personally. Recommended experience I'd probably give is the beginner level. I don't think you really need too much experience to take care of a rainbow whiptail. You gotta know UVB, you know, a basic concept of husbandry, which you kind of need for like any reptile, and then you gotta feed it live bugs, which, you know, take that as you will. Some people don't want to, some people do, but I don't know, you go to the pet store, grab some crickets, and then you call it a day. It sounds like a pretty easy task to me. Personally for me, I absolutely adore the rainbow whiptail lizard. I mean, it's like the coolest, most colorful thing in my collection at this point in time. It's probably why I really like, you know, it hasn't sold it for a week or so now, and if it doesn't sell, I'm not too upset about it because I'll keep it as a pet. I mean, it's just a really cool animal. It's definitely gonna be one of those lizards that you own and you have some friends over. They're gonna go directly to that thing and be like, whoa, what is this? A blue lizard? A blue, yellow, green lizard? This thing is fantastic. What is it? Which is, again, why I think it is so strange why these guys aren't more widely known or kept in the pet trade. But hey, who knows? Honestly, I think they're cool. I think we should revamp. I'm gonna make a reptile movement and start pumping rainbow whiptails out into the community because I want to see more blue, green, yellow lizards. Now there is only one care aspect that I feel is a really big downside as far as besides, you know, the crap personality. It's going to be, they don't live very long. They live in a roughly timeline of around 3 years, which as far as reptiles go is like unheard of. You know, we got chameleons. We think chameleons are less lived and they live like 7 or 8, but the rainbow whiptails just don't make it that long for some reason. I feel like it's kind of like having a small animal. You know, most of your hamsters, guinea pigs, I think, rats, I don't know anything about guinea pigs. I don't know why I mentioned it. But yeah, rats live like 2 or 3 years, so it's kind of like that. You know, it's the price reflects it. You know, $70, $75, cool lizard. What are you gonna do, you know? Guys, there you have it. Is the rainbow whiptail the right reptile for you? But now it's your turn. Leave me a comment in the comment section. What did you think? Now that you have some more information about the rainbow whiptail, you're like, you know what, Dakota? That's a pretty rad, a stinking rad reptile. I think I'll take you up on that offer. By the way, we do have one still available, you know. If I commented down saying it's sold, it's there. But you know, first come, first serve. We do got one of these guys here. But yeah, leave me a comment in the comment section. What did you guys think of the rainbow whiptail? And as always, if you like the video, give it a huge thumbs up. You know, we got the subscribe button down there if you did really enjoy this thing. We got a couple videos to check out. Of course, if you want to see the unboxing of these rainbow whiptails, we got that right there. We got a couple more great stuff. And then, again, the subscribe button should be maybe down there, maybe up here. Hey, they're all somewhere. That's going to wrap it up for today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Goodbye.